Ever since the invention of the automobile, man has always striven for something bigger, better, and faster. It's the thought that has driven ambition, right from the very first motoring race in the 1890s down to the latest season of Formula One. It's also the thought that has brought me here to the NCPA on a Saturday evening. I'm here to relive history, the 120-year motorsport history of German car manufacturer Mercedes-Benz. Pontons, pagodas, fintails, and even a Unimog. History had come alive for auto enthusiasts. And while these vehicles certainly had everyone's attention, there was more to be explored. Beginning with the early 19th century, where the need of the hour was to demonstrate the power of the automobile, to various accomplishments in motorsport, right down to the present. Mercedes' first ever Formula One Constructors' Championship, won at the Russian Grand Prix in Sochi last month. Photographs and chatter certainly do outweigh reading stuff from the internet, but experiencing what these vehicles can really do is another thing altogether, isn't it? The next day, a curious and excited mix of onlookers welcomed 67 cars at Nariman Point, a collection that featured cars from seven decades. The oldest, this 1929 Nürburg, Mercedes' first 8-cylinder passenger car that can hit a top speed of 100 kilometers per hour.
Old cars are like old ladies, they need constant maintenance. There's always something or the other happening to them, in spite of the fact that I run my cars every 20 days.
Another star that drew several curious eyes was this 220S, a W111 fintail, the moniker given to vehicles produced between 1959 to 1968. And then there was the 1956 four-cylinder Mercedes-Benz 190 Ponton, the mainstay make for Mercedes from 1953 to 1962.
I've got the 190 SL, which I bought probably 7-8 years back, after I myself started collecting cars on my own about 10 years back. So that car was in Calcutta, totally dilapidated, as so many cars sadly in India, and I did a full restoration job on that one.
And though cars from the 1980s and 1990s formed the majority of the participants, the conversation kept coming back to the vintage beauties, be it the pagodas or even the 170V roadsters.
This is a 1936 Mercedes 170V Roadster. It's a very unusual body shape, as you can see. Most cars that have a hood can be seen from the outside. This has a mechanism where you pull the seat out and the hood pops up, and then you just fit it up on top.
Every Saturday, Sunday, I have to try and sort of drive it. Then on Monday, it goes to the mechanic to try and sort of fine-tune it a bit, and getting parts from Germany, etc. It's a continuous challenge, but it's an enjoyable challenge. And I've got a good Parsi mechanic who looks after it, so we sort of enjoy maintaining it.
The occasion was to celebrate motorsport, but these cars were not here to race. This was an opportunity for these ladies to stretch their legs and strut their stuff over a 38-kilometer drive. And as the cars drove past the many Mumbai landmarks, one could see its evolution from the grand carriage to the aerodynamically sculpted efficiency, thanks to the developments and learnings from the racetrack. A history lesson like no other.
There is actually a lot of heritage, and we have so many enthusiasts and customers collecting heritage Mercedes-Benz cars. It's just great, and today at this event I'm overwhelmed. We have 70 or more than 70 participants starting from 1929. This is the oldest car today, yeah, getting up all the decades in the 70s and into the 80s. So it's just great, and we at Mercedes-Benz, we are so proud having all these enthusiasts and all these heritage cars here with us.
Been a lot of fan following for Mercedes purely because of the heritage. It's the oldest car maker in the world, so you expect that sort of heritage for them to have. And I think it's been a great event because we've had a lot of people coming out and enjoying their cars. Traffic police did an outstanding job managing the traffic, and that's why the event went really smoothly.
So there you have it, history, heritage and beauty coming together on a Sunday morning to give every car lover something that they will cherish for quite some time.